What I would like to talk about here is which are the data subsets that it makes sense to use for each one of the important questions we mentioned in our previous video. Given that I have access to historical data about all food product recalls and border rejections that have taken place until December 2019, classified according to the raw materials, ingredients and hazards that were linked to the recall. Is it possible to predict with high confidence how many food safety incidents we are going to have for each ingredient category in 2020? But this is not enough. There are some data selection decisions to make. Are we interested in the global picture using a very large global data set to build a generic food safety predictor? Or do we need a subset of the data only associated with specific geographical regions of interest, such as the United States or the European Union? Furthermore, should we slice the data according to the product categories that they refer to, removing irrelevant product recalls and rejections so that they do not influence the prediction? So, we got ready for some serious data preparation, splitting and also recombination work. This is typically done by splitting the real historical data into training and testing subsets. The algorithm is parameterized using the training data, and then its predictive capabilities are evaluated using the testing data. There are several data preparation and combination techniques to ensure that the model will be able to produce reliable predictions. These include multiple data splitting and cross-validation techniques, as well as ways to ensure that the train and test data distributions are similar. Then, data problems such as handling missing or inconsistent data come into play. Again, there are plenty of techniques to help address, for example, missing data values. What's the bottom line? There is going to be some serious data processing and management that needs to take place before we can deploy algorithms. Stay tuned to find out how the AI algorithms are used over all these data combinations to deliver a reliable and efficient food safety prediction service. Don't forget to subscribe to our weekly food safety intelligence newsletter to stay up to date with the latest industry news. Find the link below the video.